Established as the 76th province of Thailand in March 2011, Bueng Kan of the larger Nong Khai region in Thailand's far northeast is certainly one of the most unspoilt places in the entire kingdom. There are numerous daily flights to Udon Thani, and then it's roughly a 3-hour road trip. Eco-tourists are in for a real treat, and I suggest elevating to a place of high prominence on your list of places to go and things to do when in these parts. One of the major attractions in the region is the Phu Wua Wildlife Sanctuary, 186.5 kilometres worth, apparently an abundance of wildlife. It's located here, just on this side of the Mekong. On the other side is Laos. Offering a unique combination of homestay, trekking, village and cultural experiences, the sanctuary provides a valuable source of income for the locals. However, don't be under any five-star illusions, as this roof over your head, well, it's just that. There is a fan and a bathroom, but otherwise it's pretty much back to basics. That, of course, is part of the charm. Now, if it's peace and tranquility you're looking for, there are very few places in existence as peaceful and as tranquil as the environment we find here. Call it a wildlife sanctuary retreat, if you will. Full accommodation is available here with your very own personal guide to take you through the safari park the following day. You can choose from recreational activities such as a half basketball court, badminton court, or this fully equipped state-of-the-art modern gym, as you can see here. There's as much or as little to do as you please. Now, you'll be pleased to know that the price of accommodation here is free, absolutely free. All you pay for is electricity and water, and there's no fixed price. You pay, in fact, what you see fit. The guide, however, will cost you 400 baht per day, which is still very reasonable. This little guy is one of the rarest lizards in the world, the unique environment here offering the perfect conditions to breed safely. Located a short distance from the cabins and within the same grounds, I decided to explore the sanctuary's water source.
No drinking! No cooking. Tarai cup. Free.
You are likely to be able to explore at your leisure.
So during peak rainfall, this area is fully submerged and provides the vital water source for all the animal population within the sanctuary. As you can see now, it's barely more than a trickle, but there is still water present.
Low water levels allow a better glimpse of just what a truly picturesque place this is. While the amount of water present is entirely in the hands of Mother Nature, there is still a more than adequate supply all year round. Mid-afternoon, not much wildlife is visible, but rest assured your guides will be able to locate the animal residents, which include wild elephants, with consummate ease. A few kilometres up the road, we paid a visit to the Nong Khut Ting wetlands, one of the largest and biologically diverse in all of Thailand. Of the 76 provinces, this is the 11th most significant wetland in all of Thailand. Ecologically rich, it provides a great many resources for not only the local community, but the larger Isan province. The ecological richness comprises more than 250 species of aquatic wetland wildlife. This biodiverse marshland is home to 40 species of birds, 200 species of aquatic plants, and 20 fish species. Far from the madding crowds of Bangkok, venture a little further afield. You'll discover an untainted, pristine environment and some downtime in the midst of nature.